This is Tom Dillon, the lifetime liberal, and today is Sunday, September 16th, 2018. The title of this rant is, I Believe Women. So, within the last hour, an article came out in the Washington Post regarding Brett Kavanaugh's selection to be a Supreme Court jurist, and a woman has come out. This has been going on for about a week to 2 weeks in terms of backhanded stuff. That she has come out, she has named herself, we know who she is, she's a professional, she's 51 years old, and she clearly indicates that she felt that she was sexually assaulted by Judge Kavanaugh like 1991, 1992, when she was a 15-year-old girl. Now, a little bit of this came out earlier, Kavanaugh vehemently denied it. And the question is in reference to this. You can read the article. It gives her name. She's a professional. She was reluctant to come forward. She didn't want her name dragged through the muck. Someone released her name somewhere along the line. Reporters were showing up at her doorstep, so she has to come out. So the question is, will this be a repeat of the Anita Hill thing that happened 28 years ago, I believe? And of course, Clarence Thomas never should have been selected to be the Supreme Court jurist that he is now, because no one wanted to believe her, and they slut-shamed Anita Hill all over the place. And there were three additional women, we know that now, that would have testified to the same types of things that Anita Hill testified, but Joe Biden, who was the head Democrat on that, did not let that come up. I do believe he has said he probably made a big mistake about that. But the real thing is, what will happen now? Will Republicans go hog wild? This is the guy they want. We're going to throw it all the way through. We're going to slut shame this woman all over the place. We're going to blame the Democrats for this, etc., etc. Because once they, you know, as the president has said, you know, once you show any type of weakness, it's all over. Because once they show any weakness that they have to reassemble, they have to have another hearing, they have to have something, then his selection to the Supreme Court will go down. So if they are going to have him go, they are going to have to go behind him 100%, which means they're going to have to go after this woman completely, utterly, take her down, really. And my question is about all of this is that, hey, if this is what they're going to do right now before the election, the year of the Me Too movement, what will this do? I mean, again, I've always said we should get rid of every single Republican in there, and we still should. But this would be incredibly further evidence, especially if the Republicans back Kavanaugh now at this point, that they don't care about anything about women and that we need to get rid of all of them. And especially what's going to happen with Susan Collins, the senator, the Republican senator from Maine, and Lisa Murkowski, the Republican senator from Alaska. So what will they going to do? Are they going to do about it? So we have two or three things. What are the two senators going to do about it? What are the Republicans going to do about it? If they show any type of weakness, he's going down. If they go behind him hog wild, they're just, the only thing they can do is go after this woman completely and relentlessly. And how will this affect the upcoming election? Wow. We will see.